Hey, what's going on, guys? Hope you're having a great day. I'm just getting ready now to go to Birmingham with my friend Abby, and we're going to Martin Ford's gym to train with Martin Ford. If you don't know who Martin Ford is, he's kind of a big deal now. Like, his social media has exploded over the past 6 months. He's being featured in the new Undisputed that's being released in 4 weeks. And honestly, look, he's doing really well for himself. He's put the work in and he's finally being rewarded for it. He's a massive guy. If you haven't seen him already, he was featured on like Louis Marco's videos. He's basically been everywhere. It's crazy that I've got the opportunity to train with him and Abby today. So I'm just about to leave. Hope you guys enjoy the video.
It works both ways. Pick up your phone.
Right, just got back from the workout. That was probably one of the craziest workouts I've ever had in my entire life. You know that feeling when you can't do any more reps and your muscles are like completely fatigued and you can't do any more? When you get past that feeling and like you're literally your bones and ligaments don't feel like they can take the weight anymore, that's what every single set felt like training with Martin Ford. Funny story as well, because I didn't actually know who Martin Ford was until not that long ago, because Abby was like, okay, we're training with this guy called Martin Ford. I was like, okay, cool. I wasn't really like fazed by it. I was just like, yeah, cool. We're going to be training with someone. Like, that's a good, that's great. Not knowing until I actually met him that I'd actually been following him. I just didn't know. I didn't like put his name to his face. Like, I heard the name and I knew that was his name. I just didn't. It didn't click in my head when she said Martin Ford. And I saw him when we pulled up to the gym and I was like, oh my God, that's Martin Ford. Like, oh my God. It was crazy. It was a pleasure working out with the guy. He's really humble. He's really nice. He's really down to earth. And it was a really good workout.
My phone just died. I put it on charge because I need to call my driving instructor to sort out some driving lessons, because basically passing my driving test now is the most important thing to me.
Reason being is because I feel like life really starts when you pass your driving test. You don't need to rely on friends or family to give you lifts to places. And if anything, I can make more interesting YouTube videos because I can go and do things. I can go to different places. Put myself in different scenery. I can do car vlogs. I can just do things. I can go to different gyms, because I hate making videos at David Lloyd and Revolution every single video. Like, I want to go to Elite. I want to go to Emporium. I want to go to Ironworks. What can I think of that? Ironworks. I want to go to all these different gyms. And if anything, for me, it would make it more interesting for me, because editing a workout in the same gym, even though it's a different workout, in the same gym every time, I love editing videos and making them like as interesting as possible. But when like you're seeing the same thing over and over again, it gets boring for me. So like, I can't even imagine how boring it gets for you. So passing my test is like kind of like the most important thing right now.
My dad's just making some dinner now. He has this mad concoction of literally everything. Like, he's got cucumber, cheese, chicken, everything in it. I don't even know what it is. And my brother has piratas, and they're basically like fajitas, but they're cooked and fried in oil, and they've got like sweet chili sauce and rajita sauce, and they're kind of like fajitas, but they're just better. And then later on, me and my dad and my brother are thinking about going in the hot tub because we haven't done that in ages. Like, he spent so much money on this hot tub, and we just like barely ever use it, but we're probably gonna use it tonight.
Hey, George.
Yeah. What are you doing? Oh, my carbs. Leg day.
I remember it's the best few hours now. Me and my dad and my brother, we've all just been sitting down in the living room watching some TV, spending time as a family, really. I didn't see my dad that much, so getting the chance to like spend this time with him is like real cool. But we finished watching TV. I'm about to go do some cardio and get laid up. Wearing my stronger top that I got like 3 years ago, my very first body power, but it's big, it's baggy. And it makes you sweat, so. I thought that I'd like do my cardio now because me and my dad and my brother, I think I'm going in the hot tub later on, like I said earlier. But I was getting really tired, so I thought like there is no way I'm gonna wanna do my cardio after getting in the hot tub and like relaxing, so I'm gonna go do that now. It's about 10 o'clock at night right now. It's real late. Why are we going in the hot tub at like 11 o'clock at night? I don't know, but we're gonna do it anyway. Now for cardio. By the way, does anyone notice anything different about my wrist? No? There's no watch on it. I've been wearing the same exact watch now for about a year of my life. Like, I never take it off. I sleep in it, I shower in it, everything. But my brother, we were kind of like fighting and stuff, like play fighting, and he broke it. Now, because I don't have that on my wrist, I literally feel naked. Like, it's been on my wrist for that long. Like, you know when you have a bracelet and you wear it for that long and then it like gets like broken or like taken off you, or you just like, you just take it off, you feel like exposed. Because you didn't have it on, like that's how I feel right now. So I need to either get that repaired or just like buy a new watch. Right, so I got my BCAAs, just get my shoes on. I've got my headphones and my music. Let's go do some cardio. Right, so I just got done with cardio. I was just having like a little rest before I headed back, because my dad lives just down that road down there. But I was like kind of like resting up against this like railing on this bridge, and this guy walked past. He was like, "Bro, are you okay?" I was like, "Yeah, I'm fine." He's like, "Are you sure?" I was like, "Yeah, I'm good." Like, he's like, "Are you gonna jump? Are you sure? Are you gonna jump off the bridge?" I was like, "No, like, of course I'm not gonna jump off the bridge. Like, what are you talking about?" Just got back. My dad is asleep on the sofa. Like I said, he would be asleep, but honestly, I walked through the door and like my tiredness kind of just hit me. So I'm gonna get to bed. I'm gonna have one more meal and a protein shake and just like kind of just like get to bed. It's 11:30 right now, so. I think that's it for the video, guys. I really enjoyed it. If you did enjoy this video, give it a like. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.